Tesla announced its entry into the semi-truck market in 2017 with the introduction of its first heavy truck, the simply named Semi. While the rig was promised sooner, it took Tesla 5 years to deliver its first electric haulers on December 1, 2022. That's right, Tesla has now delivered an actual production semi-truck. It will go to PepsiCo, which displayed two trucks with Pepsi and Frito Lay branding, as well as two others in white during Tesla's announcement of the Semi's realization. Welcome to Tech Heaven, and in this video we'll take a look at the Tesla Semi and latest updates you need to know. Elon Musk arrived at the event in one of the white Semis, then apologized and thanked everyone for their patience in waiting 5 years for the Semi to become a reality. He also explained why Tesla is building a Semi, which is apparently in response to semi-trucks being responsible for around 20% of emissions despite accounting for only 1% of vehicle sales in the United States. He also stated that living near a highway with diesel semi-trucks running around is very unhealthy, as well as how much noise pollution they produce. That is why, according to Musk, Tesla's Semi is in line with its goal of creating sustainable energy and why it is producing a vehicle that is not typical of most car manufacturers. The fact that Musk drove one of those trucks right towards the audience served a purpose other than simply showing one in motion. Musk explained during the presentation that driving the Semi is similar to driving a Tesla car. This includes its driving performance as well. He claims it has 3 times the power of a diesel Semi on the roads today and looks like an elephant moving like a cheetah, fast to accelerate and fast to brake. According to Tesla, the Tesla Semi will have a 500-mile range thanks to its 1000-volt battery power system. Oh, and more vehicles will be equipped with the 1kV system in the near future. That will be important later on. Tesla also stated that the Semi's drivetrain, HVAC, hardware, controls, and software are all based on Tesla technology and equipment that is already in use. Especially its drive system, which is a triple motor setup with one axle based on the dual motors found in the Model S and X Plaid and used during acceleration. At a constant speed, the motors decouple from the axles, allowing them to freewheel and improve the Semi's efficiency. The single motor takes over and is responsible for all highway driving. Despite the coupling and decoupling, Musk claims that the transition from the acceleration axle engagement to standard driving will be seamless. By the way, if you're watching us for the first time, make sure to hit that subscribe button and turn on notifications so you can enjoy our future videos while getting updated. Getting back to the topic? Tesla had videos demonstrating the truck's durability and survivability, including footage of it running over objects, through deep puddles, loose dirt roads, snow-covered roads, and even washboard paths, to demonstrate its readiness to tackle a wide range of driving scenarios. Tesla also stated that its Semi were running around the clock between Sparks, Reno, Tahoe, and Fremont to ensure they were ready to meet the demands of heavy hauling. The Semi can tow up to 82,000 pounds gross vehicle weight, which is the legal limit. This is 2,000 pounds more than diesel trucks are allowed, a concession made by regulators to offset the weight of an electric Semi battery pack. The single highway motor is more than enough to drive it normally, as demonstrated by Tesla, who took it to the Donner Pass and filmed it carrying its full load and passing a diesel Semi while accelerating. Another advantage of the Tesla Semi over traditional ICE semi-trucks is regenerative braking. The Tesla Semi's pilots don't have to worry about missing a gear or messing up the Jake brake as it descends those grades. Because of the regen, it also uses fewer brakes than an ICE truck. When we get to the bottom of the hill, we have cold brakes, Musk explained, which is a safety improvement for the driver and other drivers on the road. Tesla claims to have included impressive safety technology in the Semi. According to Tesla, its unique motor setup, as well as traction and chassis controls, are capable of preventing a truck from jackknifing. According to Musk, everything is seamless to the driver. Tesla then displayed a graph of a 500-mile test run from Fremont to San Diego, with the vehicle hauling just under its 80,000-pound capacity as a fully production model with no aero tricks. Musk promised that Tesla would release the entire 8-hour video without cuts, but he only showed a time-lapse version tonight. Tesla Semi never stopped charging during the entire 500-mile journey, though there was one break for the driver to use the restroom and take the mandatory commercial driver break period. Tesla claims to have driven down I-5 at around 82 miles per hour in a fully enclosed trailer. Aside from its large 1000-volt battery pack for the 500-mile run, the semi's aerodynamics are another advantage. It works in tandem with the trailer it tows in order to minimize drag and maximize speed. Overall, the semi consumes only about 2 kWh per mile, putting the potential battery capacity at 1 MWh. That's more than 33 times what a typical home consumes in a day. Tesla's innovations extend beyond electronics. The interior is designed with the driver in mind, and not just because of the centralized seating. First, it has standard wireless charging and the USB-C port for mobile devices, as well as convenient storage areas for those devices. The standard Tesla Semi is also larger than a typical day cab truck, which, if you've never been inside one, can be surprisingly cramped. Anyone over 6 feet tall will be perfectly at ease. It also has productivity-enhancing features such as a one-button rear dump to assist with trailer loading, as well as built-in safety checks that the driver can operate from within the cab to help meet safety checks while on the road. Finally, the Semi, unlike Tesla's most recent passenger vehicles, has a round steering wheel, but retains the standard Tesla wheel touch controls and scroll wheel. It also has dual touchscreen monitors for multiple views, allowing the driver to monitor the load, check blind spots, and use guidance without having to switch views on a single screen. Rather than using a portrait screen layout like the S or X, both screens are in landscape mode with a steering wheel in the middle. Another surprise was Tesla demonstrating its new version 4 charging system, a 1 MW DC charging system with immersion cooling that offers 3 times the power density while also allowing for a smaller cable compared to a non-immersion cool cable. Tesla also stated that this charging will be used on Cybertruck and will be available at Tesla superchargers next year. The charging capability allows semis to charge in a reasonable amount of time, which Tesla has previously stated means a 70% charge in just 30 minutes. Musk did not elaborate or specify the recharge time in the most recent update. The 1 MW is more than 33 times the power that the average home uses in a day, and it is likely that more than one semi will be charging at the same time at any charging location. Now that production has begun and deliveries have begun as a result of PepsiCo initial order, the question is whether other trucking and freight companies will follow suit. Since the Tesla Semi was first announced 5 years ago, Anheuser-Busch, Walmart, UPS, and 12 other North American companies have committed to at least one order. Other European brands have also stated that they will order semis for their fleets around the same time. Will more brands follow now that Tesla has demonstrated the production model? How many owner-operators will order an EV semi that is as simple to drive as a Tesla car? We'll have to wait and see, but if Musk's claims of cost savings on diesel and brake consumption are true and Tesla can build and deliver these in large numbers, it's difficult to argue against the investment, at least for local and medium-range hauling duties. And with that being said, it's time to end our video, but before that, we'd like to know, what are your thoughts about the Tesla Semi? Let us know in the comments. Like this video and make sure to subscribe to the channel for more amazing videos like this. We'll see you in the next video.